Good, relevant time of day to you all. Welcome to Luck as Seamus, and I'm Seamus. You're watching Handlabber Games. You can follow us at Handlabber on Twitter, Facebook and YouTube, and Handlabber Games right here on Twitch. Aeon's End, Bottom of the Ninth, One Day Dungeon, Center of the Multiverse, and Spirit Hand are currently available to iOS for iOS, Android, and PC, Mac, and Linux via Steam, and as always, via good old analog cardboard and ink. You can get these games and more information at handlabber.com. Handlabber believes in civil rights for everyone and in being as inclusive as possible, so any comments or activity actively working against that goal is not welcomed and will not be tolerated. Hello, Diffmaker. How are you this fine Monday evening? I hope your time gets better. Right, let's take a look. I'm just going to grab. Ooh, okay, so that's for next week. Who shall we take this week? Anybody got suggestions of people they want to see? Go with those guys. Let's go with Gloomy. I haven't picked up Gloomy in a long time. Okay. So, Dragon Tamer starts with here be dragons, protein snack, strategize, and we fight as one. Skulltex is paired between the shots. Debilitating Arrow and Silver Arrow. Impact has Accelerated Collision, Escape Velocity, Gravitational Lensing, and Spatial Finesse. And Cypher has Cyber Integration, Cyborg Punch, Heuristic Algorithm, and Rebuilt to Succeed. Yes, she does appear to be an Archer type. Maybe going up against somebody a little slower, like Gloom Mover, will give me more time to take a look at her. And the others. Ooh. Let's go with Impact for now. Okay. Okay. We get Algo. Okay. Okay, let's see, I think it's called this turn. If there were no cards to destroy this turn, you gain 2 HP. Okay. Yep. Destroy an Alcon. Okay. So that's a play and a power to do one target, 3 projectile damage. That seems not great. Impact. Okay. 6 plus 3 non-character targets and play with 2 or fewer HP. Place those targets on the bottom of this. Okay. So, I reckon we do this. Do 2 damage to her. Then play this. Skip that. And then put her and 2 zombies under his deck. Okay. Well, that seems to be the only useful thing I can do. Interplay. I reckon that's going to be most useful currently with Dragon Tamer. God damn it, I just got rid of her. Okay. No, let's just kill that. Okay, let's check what they're doing. Okay. Whenever a target destroyed, discard the top card. Can it use an artifact to play and destroy this card? I think they're going to temporarily swap off. Okay. Okay, we're not going to destroy a card, but we'll take the damage. Okay. I think I'm just going to start building up her arrow collection. Ooh. So she can heal and we'll see if we can get something interesting going. And that's no good. That seems useful. finesse. Let's kill the spatial finesse. Okay, the first time this current play select a player, cheat that guard as part of their deck for the rest of the game. When this current play, a hero from its deck gains 4 HP and deals each of the hero target 1 final damage. Then move this card beneath the top 2 cards of its deck face down. Okay, so we want to give it to somebody who won't have damage boosts, so that's likely to be Cypher. Don't have anything there, so let's go with the oh damn, I didn't want to do that. Don't want to move that. Yay, another dragon. Okay. We're going to take extra damage on Cypher because he can heal. And we will try and kill the Forbidden Knowledge. Because it is forbidden! So let's bring up Hydra. What's your target's 1 melee damage? Not great, but still is damage. Okay, you play this card in the play phase. By you. Okay. I'll just get him. Okay. Alright, so first time this card is played, select a player, treat this card as part of their deck for the rest of the game. When this card ends play, increase damage dealt to my targets from its decks by one until the start of their next turn, then move this card between the top two cards of its decks face down. Let's give that to Scarlet X. Fast following. And the pouch of bones. It's most damage at the moment. Yes. This one on target 3. Okay. Mm. $2 each. Okay. Oh, look, it's going to go away because of Patch of Bones. Stupid Seamus. I saw Retin Morg. I did see Retin Morg. Let's put it on impact. Times it's just ongoing cards. That's kind of not going to happen. And that is. So impact is further on, so we've got a better chance of destroying it. Tamer. Okay, so that's leaving me with three powers, so Indigo Ping goes away. Okay. Destroy an arrow. Here's an extra power. Let's kill that. No use anymore. So that's another 2 damage. actually. Let's spread the love. Skulltex needs cards. So, put onto deck, when a hero from its deck peels itself one of the target one psychic damage each and plays a card. Then move the card and throw up to cards and just face down. Play a card. I can go on Cypher. Okay, well. Oh, I don't want that. That's absolutely terrible. I'm going to have to put into Cypher's hand because he doesn't have a. Well, that sucked. And there's the drop. Do I want back? You do 3 targets 1 melee damage, you do 1 target 2 fire damage. No, it doesn't. Okay, I'm not sure why that didn't let me do fire damage. Okay.
is, which I can't play. Everyone, use the power. Let's just use this. These cards. Okay, Dragon Tamer. Just got two cards. Next, destroy a card. Impact, destroy one card. Put another dragon into play. This is additional powers. Okay, I'm not sure why Elgor isn't dealing damage, but he's not. Unless I'm missing something, which is entirely possible. That's no good. That's no good. That's, and he was being a little damaged this turn. Right, okay. Well, he's not drawing cards then. honestly. The environment appears to be doing way more to me than... Oh, I shouldn't have said anything. Oh, that. That's death. And there goes all my lovely augments. This is... They just got to go. side, I've got the wrong way around. You have no cards to play, you have no powers to use. Oh, they stay in the deck when, okay. Oh, let's go on impact and see if we can kill it before it comes around his turn. We don't need that at the moment. Okay. Three is like most damage. I may not want to have done that, but I reckon I should be able to kill that zombie. Combat. There is a dragon there, it's Tortuga. Okay. Okay, that seems like a nice power. And that is 4 damage. Kill the zombie. Impact should be able to kill the drum. Excuse me. I can do that with the power. Ah, I couldn't do that with the power. Oh well. I'm going to just skip and take the damage this turn. I'm not going to play that card. I'm going to keep that to heal Tortuga. So the first thing I'm going to do is heal Tortuga. And then Draco is going to start beating up Sablepin. Okay, we can just destroy a card. Okay. finally going to get around to killing you. Okay. Interesting. I'm going to put that back into you for killing more later. Let's go to the disable pin. I don't think I have any ongoing destruction left. Well, that's of no use. Yeah, you know. Well, let's just run that ongoing card. That does not seem to have any effect. Oh, not again. That's true. Draco, got plus one damage. back into Draco. See, there's one relic left in his deck. And that card does nothing. That card does nothing. She's going to double skip. Okay, I'm not sure what happened there. Ophidia has the second highest HP. That is not good! Okay, Tortuga is trying to redirect damage to himself. Draco will take. Oh, it's each hero target. Choose for me. Yes. Bye bye, Scarlet X. Okay, one human use power now. Okay. Yeah, pretty much. I think I'm about to have this. And that'll leave the zombie impact to deal with the zombie. Yay, the grimoire! Can we kill it? Should we want to put it below Draco? Yes. I do think it is possible. I'm not going to do the deer, I'm going to do the damage. Yes, we've got it. Now we just have to survive to the start of this turn. That was close, and that was long, and that was hard fought. And usually, Grunu Weaver isn't that tough. Oh, hey, Mark. So, new game. It's going to have to be fast, because we have 25 minutes left. So, we're going to play Baron Blade. Pick your heroes, please, people. Anyone from Standard Games, or all the mods. Except guys. I refuse to play guys. Cricket. Trailblazer. Where is Trailblazer? I don't care if guys is sad. Come on, anyone else? Pick a hero, any hero. Wah. Burn, burnish all. Luminary. Because beating up Baron Blade shouldn't be so tough for him. Where's Luminary gone? Luminary. He's going at the front. And environment. You know, if we're doing... Oh yes, absolutely first slot. Wardengrad! Because, you know, where else should Baron Blade fight Luminary? Except for, you know, control of Wardengrad. So, Luminary starts with Disposable Defender, Hasten Victory, Regression Turret, and Technologically Stable. Cricket starts with Desynchronization, Sound Masking, Swarming, Frequency, and Voice Mimicry. Ra begins with Drawn to the Flame, pair of Flame Spikes, and Wrathful Gaze. And Trailblazer starts with Parting Gift, Uncharted Grounds, Vantage Point, and Wasteland Wanderer. Ooh. Okay. Oh, well, if you insist, Luminary bought gas. So, Luminary is appearing to, do whatever the hell he feels like. Okay, we'll trash that one. We'll trash that one. That'll go to the top of her deck. That'll go to the top of his deck. And we'll top deck that. And we will top deck that, and then one player will have trade base for that. Well, this is a wide ranging choice of who we want to reduce the damage of. Well, well. I'm making me do that now while there's nothing in the trash. So leave me play the top card of your deck. Draws a card and you can use a power. Well. Oh, he only discards two cards. Who else do you want to play the top card of their deck? Trailblazer. We don't play a position while that's in play. The mobile platform isn't in play. Why are you still getting a bonus from it? Oh, sorry, yes, that one. I was thinking of the mobile defense platform that I blew up. So we're going to blow up this. Oh, actually, no, let's go back. Oh, it's specifically my devices. Oh well. Okay, you're not actually managing to do anything with that. So. Okay. Excuse me. Nice job, Cricket. Dangerous vision. And we'll cue that and put a backlash generator. It's worth it. Oh. Okay, so if I play a position. Targets to fire damage. I don't have another position to play. More plague battalions. Let's get rid of the. No, I'll keep the reaction tab. I can't use all these Doomsday devices. So we'll get rid of that. I just got the top card of his deck. Okay. Oh dear, I forgot that. I like climbing harness. I need to hurry up and flip power blade. It's always the 7 damage, but you know what? It flips it. Yeah, I can blow up one of these. Oh, hey, that was a nice time to regain 10 hit points. Minion prime number. I will show you the mods I am using at the as soon as I finish this fight. It should not be too long. This is okay. Oh, hey, look, all the fire damage is about to appear. I'm not sure why claiming a harness to plus 4 that turn. Oh no, the Seaward Battle Drone has been destroyed. I must discard a card. Not out of position to play, so I'm better off healing. Okay, that's random enough. I suppose it would help Lady Viewers on his front. Another Blade Battalion? Okay, so I can get Luminary to use a power. Luminary will kill my own blade with the orbital death laser. Luminary. Thank you. Oh no, what is Baron Blade, what is poor Luminary going to do against Baron Blade? I have no idea. Ooh. Well, crap. That's annoying. Blow it up. God damn it. I guess I just wanted to finish him off himself. There we go. Okay, menu, you want to see. So if we click on the mods here. The mods we have are the cauldron, which is massive set. Not all 55 decks are in here yet, but they're well on their way and there's more coming next week. Darkmind is a single deck, which is a new villain, which is a single villain created from the Oblivion Scion Darkmind. Uberport is a group of is a group. You've seen a couple of them. You saw Dragon Tamer and Skulltex. Viduins is four heroes. Cassian Quiris, Spellforger, Trailblazer. A massive number of variants. And the Aeon Dungeons right here, which we can't show. Spooky Ghostwriter Comics is the heroes Escalata and Gold Dragon, who are both really fun, and the Elysia Circuits. So yes, lots of five mods there. If anybody knows of any other mods that would like to get shown, please drop me a note on Discord. You can find me there as either Shames the Hug Monster or Face on Toast, depending on the Discord. You can also find me on Board Game Geek as Face on Toast, but I am in the handle of a Discord and quite a few other mod discords. But that's it for tonight. Thank you for joining me. It's been a lot of fun. Come back tomorrow in just a minute more than 24 hours time, and you should have John with Handle Arbiter Live and maybe Jeremy. At the moment, he's been doing a lot of demoing of the new content for Branch and Claw for Spirit Island. On Thursday, we have Dolphin's Dive, the more strategically minded dive into the various Handle Arbor games. On Saturdays, we have Spirit Island Saturdays, where we play Spirit Island on Saturday. That's, you'll usually find myself, Lou, John, and Jeff Dugan, and occasionally other people, including yourselves. If you want to be a guest on Spirit Island Saturdays, just click down the bottom for the Point Labras. And if you've got, I think it's 20,000, you too can be on Spirit Island Saturdays. And then on Sundays, starting an hour earlier than the other Handle Arbor streams, is Tales from the Archive with Zach from another Letdown Media. Zach may be guesting here next week. I'm kind of hoping he will, but we'll have to work that out. But Tales from the Archive is a more story-driven look at Sentinels, which is generally a lot of fun. He will often play with silly stipulations that make the game so much harder for himself. And then, you know... And then back here on Mondays for me with Luck of the Seamus and more mods. So, thank you very much for joining me, and I hope to see you sometime soon. Take care. Night-night.